Welcome to the final episode of the Wisconsin Employer Vaccine Forum. The Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation is leveraging our wealth of partners and connections, as well as our platform, to offer employers insights into a vaccinated workforce. I'm Missy Hughes. I'm Secretary and CEO of the Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation. And this is a series that we've put together to help share some of the key questions and concerns that face business owners and leaders as vaccinations have become widely available. We know that the state's economic well-being is tied to public well-being. All through this pandemic, we have walked along economic health and public health side by side. And so we want to help our businesses address concerns about vaccination and get to the place where we have a vaccinated workforce. And you know, today, more than ever, we're seeing how critically important that is. Today, we have guests who represent both our statewide health considerations and regional economic needs. So I'm very thrilled to be able to talk with Dr. Jeff Podhoff and Sheila Nyberg. And I'm going to ask each of them to introduce themselves. So Dr. Podhoff, why don't you go first?
Yeah, I'm Jeff Podhoff. I work for UW Health down in Madison, Wisconsin. I'm an emergency medicine physician, but also chief quality officer for the organization, and have been, you know, intimately involved in a lot of the planning and preparation, execution of our COVID plan over the now last, you know, year and a half. And happy to talk about vaccination, both our experience, what we're seeing in the state, yeah, even nationally. There's just a lot of stuff going on right now.
Great. And Sheila, can you introduce yourself?
I'm Sheila Nyberg, the director for Clark County Economic Development Corporation and for the Tourism Bureau of Clark County. I have had the privilege of being in this position 16 years. We have a beautiful, beautiful, very rural area that we're very proud of, but the ruralness of it brings unique opportunities and unique challenges. My background has been in economic development and business growth and tourism for all of my life. And so I am very interested in helping continue to grow forward, that we prosper during this COVID time and after we can move through COVID into the next steps of our life. So I look forward to working with you all.
Great, thank you, Sheila. So doctor, can you give us an understanding of where Wisconsin stands with the rollout of the vaccine statewide and in different counties, and certainly with the rise of the Delta variant, how that's playing into the current dynamic?
Yeah, you know, early on when vaccines first became available, we didn't have enough supply to keep up with demand. We were vaccinated at a very high rate. You know, as the months went on, that demand started to decrease. And as of today, we currently have 49.5% of Wisconsin residents who are eligible vaccinated. So compared to the rest of the country, we're a little bit below average, but doing better than some places. You know, the real story around vaccination in Wisconsin is similar with what we've seen with politics, is we're very divided. We have areas that have relatively high rates of vaccination and areas with very low rates of vaccination. So for example, if you take our highest vaccinated county, which is Dane County, 67.7% of people in Dane County are vaccinated. And then, you know, way up north in Bayfield County, something's going on up there because they're vaccinated at 60.9%. But the story is very different in other places. Sheila's County, for example, Clark County, currently only 27.9% of people are vaccinated. And if you go to Taylor County, just a little ways away from there, 27.2%. You go to some of our more urban areas, Milwaukee, they're at 47%. Milwaukee County, Brown County with Green Bay, 49.8%. La Crosse County is a little bit higher at 55.7%. And then Marathon with Wausau is at 45.2%.
So can you explain just real quickly for us a little bit about how the Delta variant is impacting whether you're vaccinated and non-vaccinated and what the recommended behavior is right now?
Before Delta, if you were vaccinated, not only were you not going to get real sick from the disease, you likely weren't going to get any symptoms at all. But even if you did, you weren't going to be able to transmit it to other people. And it was that last piece there that resulted in the CDC reducing those mitigation efforts around masking and distancing for vaccinated people. Now, with Delta variant, that has changed. We've studied Delta variant and we see breakthrough cases. They're still not common. A vaccinated people, maybe 10 to 15% of those who are fully vaccinated will have virus in their nose after they've been exposed to an infected person. But what did change is now those people who were fully vaccinated when we look at how much virus is in their nose, it is the same as those who are unvaccinated, meaning that now vaccinated people can actually transmit the disease to other folks, whether they're unvaccinated, the risk there would be high, or even other vaccinated people, they could have those breakthrough cases. Now, the good news about vaccines is you still get protection against severe disease, you get protection against death. That's an insurance that folks that are unvaccinated do not have. But it raises some additional concerns around masking behavior in those who are vaccinated. But once you come into indoor locations, especially indoor locations that are crowded, in areas of the state that have high prevalence of the disease there, there is a reasonable expectation or reasonable reason to think that vaccinated people might want to put their mask on there. So one, they don't expose themselves and then be a potential transmitter of the disease to other folks, you know, until cases decrease or until vaccination rates get higher, that Delta starts to burn out. So I don't think it's going to be a super long recommendation. It's not going to go on for forever. But for the time being, as we start to see this uptick in Delta variant COVID in the state, vaccinated people masking in indoor locations where transmissibility is currently high is probably a reasonable thing to do.
So let's bring it back to economic development and the state of economic health. Why is this conversation about getting vaccinated so critically important on a public health basis, but also on an economic health basis?
Over the last couple of weeks, I think you've seen this shift a little bit in saying, you know what, we're not so fond of making vaccines mandatory. But when we look at the alternative, which is this continual up-down cycle of the pandemic getting better, the pandemic getting worse, our businesses just can't tolerate that. And they're making that difficult decision of saying, you know what, we don't want to, but we probably need to start thinking about mandating vaccines because the alternative just isn't sustainable for us.
Sheila, can you tell us a little bit about Clark County and what businesses have been experiencing there? How have businesses adapted to keep their employees and their customers safe?
I sure can. We have international companies, we have larger manufacturers, we have very small mom and pop shops up and down the avenue, we have a lot of restaurants, tourism. So from all over the gamut, everyone has really made it very personal at their company. All the companies that we work with have really been watching and monitoring day after day after day, every step to keep employees safe. They've done different shifting around, split shifts, testing, of course, the sanitizing, the masking, the, you know, the distancing. Everything is being practiced to the best of their ability for the good of the business side of it. And whether you be a large or a small or a medium, they're all looking at it from, what about my company and my business and keeping my business alive?
So, you know, throughout this, one of the kind of hidden gems of this, if there can be one, is folks recognizing how incredibly important our Main Street and small businesses are for the vitality of our communities. Sheila, in particular, you know, the small businesses, the restaurants and the cafes, the little retail stores, how have they found success as they've headed into this moment of reopening? And what are some of the challenges?
They're very astute to their customer, and the small businesses have really talked to the customer. What is your preference? The best thing they've done was, you know, pick it up at the door. Call me early. I'll have it packaged for you. You know, I'll have it delivered. Those types of ingenuity that we were forced into in the beginning and them ramping up very quickly to accept that and deal with it because they are small and they can do that very quickly.
So I'm wondering if you can tell us a little bit about vaccination in Clark County. Maybe you don't have the exact statistics in front of you, but what's the conversation around vaccination like in Clark County?
The conversation was being shared about, what do we want today? How do we get the message out? How do we repeat that message so we're consistent? That was very important. The urgency in the beginning, as the doctor had mentioned, was right there. We were all standing in line. We couldn't get in to get our vaccination fast enough. Well, we're not very good at reminding folks, or we haven't found that avenue to remind folks we're in a different ball game. And that has been, I feel, a struggle, that what's the alternative? Having that real serious conversation is very important, that this is different. This is a different time and place than it was 5 weeks ago. how do we continue to have that conversation with updated scientific information, encouraging and almost, you know, asking folks to really get vaccinated because we want to see them tomorrow?
One of the challenges that I think employers face is at the end of the day, they're probably going to have, you know, some number of employees that aren't vaccinated. So if you were to give some advice to that employer, what would it be?
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right. So the idea that everyone can get a vaccine, although it is going to be a large majority of folks who will be able to get vaccinated, you will have to figure out, you know, what are we going to do with folks who are unvaccinated and need to be in our environments? And really, I would approach this from the public health perspective. So if you have unvaccinated people, you understand that they pose a higher risk to the rest of your employees, to your customer base. How can you reduce the risk that they might, you know, expose other employees to? So the first thing is probably some sort of policy that requires them to be masked when they're in the facility. Outdoors, maybe not so much, but certainly in the facility, you want to have them masked because the likelihood that that's the person who has the disease that's going to then spread it to other folks, whether vaccinated or unvaccinated, is high. You know, the other thing that we're hearing is, you know, regular testing. So if you're unvaccinated and you're at high risk of actually carrying the disease, it would be great to know if you have it because you're probably going to feel okay before you come to work and likely infect other people. So the typical cadence is about twice a week testing, PCR better than antigen-based, but the convenience of antigen-based testing might make it more desirable for employers. And then that's a way to say, you know what, we understand you can't be vaccinated, but we're going to get you tested twice a week to make sure that you're not infected and, you know, putting other people at risk. And then when you're here, we're just going to have you wear a mask so that you're at a lower risk to folks. And if you do those things, I think you can, you know, pretty significantly reduce the risk that those who are unable to be vaccinated pose to both, you know, your workers and those folks that might be coming into your business.
Yeah. Doctor, what do you think are some of the biggest challenges to vaccine adoption?
I think there's a lot out there. You know, one is we know some people are still concerned about the safety of vaccines. And I think, you know, one of the things that led to that, that we didn't have back when we did polio inoculations, smallpox inoculations, is it's really easy to come to your opinion and then find information online that confirms or supports your position. And we find that people anchor on that initial thought that they had. So way back in maybe even February, March, folks are like, I'm pretty sure vaccines aren't safe. And then they kind of tune out to any other information that might refute that. And we're having a hard time reaching them because they're still saying things that we know aren't true. You know, if I have the vaccine, I won't be able to have children. If I have the vaccine, it's going to hurt me down the road. Like, you know, we don't know how it's going to work. And that has been a hard group to reach just because they're anchored on it, you know, so tightly. And then I think the other group, it really falls into this camp of, you know, don't tell me what to do people who, you know, just don't want to get vaccinated because someone said it was a good idea. And they dig in on that. And unfortunately, with the ease of finding folks that are like-minded, you start to think that you belong to this large majority of people when in fact that position may not be as popular as they think. So I think we have our work cut out there.
This question of people being driven now by fear, and you know, we don't want to, you know, have people acting out of fear. Mandates are, you know, certainly something that some employers are considering. If you're an employer and you've got some employees who are really struggling with getting the vaccine, do you see policies around mandates or incentives? I'd be curious of both of you how you feel about that.
I've heard this morning and yesterday some companies that are making it mandatory to be vaccinated at their company in the next weeks ahead. They will be implementing that. That's a good thing to start hearing. How to encourage more companies to take that lead. Finding a way to help encourage and get that message straight out, straightforward, as hard as we can, so people understand the risk, but then also seeing that encouraging local policies by company, I think is if that can happen first, that would be the best thing for everyone.
And Doctor, what do you see as far as, you know, incentives versus mandates? What do you think is going to be most effective to overcome some of the differences in vaccine rates that we're seeing throughout Wisconsin.
I don't think anyone wants to go to mandates. I think we'd rather have conversations. We'd rather talk about, you know, why don't you want to be vaccinated? How can I get you there? But, you know, when that doesn't work at some point, I think folks are balancing this. Like, you know, we have all kinds of things where we mandate things when it's in the greater good of the public to have these things done. And it doesn't just impact individual folks. So I think that's why we're starting to see mandates. You know, we've had vaccination mandates in air quotes before for different diseases. And there's other things that we require folks to do, whether they're employees or in our community, just because if we don't do those things, everyone suffers. It actually impacts all of us. It impacts our ability to have a workforce. It impacts our ability to get out of this pandemic. And it increases the likelihood that we have a variant come along that actually requires all of us to go back and get revaccinated.
Getting a vaccine is a really a personal decision, right? You're getting a shot in your own arm and you're having something put in your body. But this has now become a community decision. And it's, you know, that's, I guess, really the concept of herd immunity is, you know, supporting your community and helping to protect your community from the virus. So I hope that we can continue with these messages and continue to share the importance of getting vaccinated. You know, on behalf of the small businesses that I represent and that Sheila represents, you know, we cannot continue to have this back and forth and up and down. It is just too hard on our businesses. And, you know, it doesn't matter what size business, they are struggling to survive this. They've come this far and they deserve our support. Is there anything else either of you would like to add today?
I would like to say that I totally agree. How do we get back to whatever that normal can be? Because this supply chain, everything is still upside down and just unbalanced. That unless we get the vaccination, unless we find a way for ourselves to take the steps to help it get back to whatever that normal can be, we're constantly going to be fighting what we've had for the last year plus.
Thank you again for joining WEDC as we continue to share and connect you to resources that can support businesses across Wisconsin. To learn more about the resources that we have, whether it comes to vaccination or work culture, you can view any of our Vaccine Forum episodes at www.weareallin.com/vaccine.